Hello everyone, hope you all are doing great, and today we are going to make abstract face. Okay, so for that we require sheet, any size sheet. Here I'm using A4 size sheet, some colors, crayons, sketch pens, and if you want you can use paints also, that's up to you. So the first step is we are going to divide our page vertically and horizontally. We're just going to mark the midpoints, the center. Okay, so I just fold my paper and I'll just open it. Okay, so I've got one center here. Same I'm going to do it horizontally like this, and I'll just mark. So I've got two centers, one is this, another one is this. So with the help of a pencil I'll just draw a line. Okay, one horizontal line, one sweeping line, and one standing line like this. With free hand, just free hand draw two lines. Okay, so we have got the center. Now what are we going to do is, we are going to start with the center. Now I'm going to put my finger like this. Okay, so this part, this line should be in the center. Okay, should be in the center. So I've got one here, one here, so I'll just mark two marks, one here, another one here. So I've got this line, I'll just bold it. Okay, I've got this line. Now the second step, the third step, first was just dividing your paper. Second was marking this nose. So this will be a nose. Okay. And now just two diagonal lines like this. Two diagonal lines like this. And now we are going to join this line with the end of our paper. Okay. So you can use scale also, or you can just join it freehand. So here I'll use scale to be more precise. I'll just draw line here, one here, another one right here. All right. Okay. So I've got my nose like this. Now we don't need this line, okay? We don't need this line. You can erase it or you can just keep it. No issues. The second one. Now, okay, the third was this one. The fourth, we're going to make the lips. Okay, now leave, just put two fingers, okay? This much space should be there, and draw the lips. One sleeping line like this. Again, I'm telling you, just put two fingers like this. So you'll just go get some space and then draw semicircle like this. Just be careful that this line should be this much, okay? The sleeping line which you're going to draw should be adjacent to your nose, okay? Should be parallel. Now this one, the lower part of the lip. Okay, you can just draw simple lips like this also. Just add some V to the upper lip. Okay, like this. Okay, we are done with the nose, we are done with the lips. Now with the face, what we are going to do, we have marked these two lines now, we have marked these two points. We are just going to sew till here. Okay, again put two fingers and just mark one point here. So we are going to join this and this point. We are going to join these two points with a curve like this, with a semicircle like this. Okay. Now we're done with this semicircle. We're done with the face. Now if you want to make neck, you can make neck also. Just two lines like this. Okay, now the eye. So let's start from the left eye first. What we are going to do, we are going to mark one point in the left side of the sheet. Okay, suppose leave two fingers and mark one point. Okay, and just make a curve like this, touching the nose. Right, the lower, just leave one finger. Like this. Same the right side of the eye, the right eye. So this line is touching this point. So I'll just mark a light line in both the points so that these are my points. Now I'll just draw the eye. Now the eyeballs. One here, one here. Draw small circles on both the sides in the center. Okay. So your drawing is ready. Now what you're going to do, you're going to outline it with black bold marker or black sketch pen, whatever you have. Let's just outline. Okay, let's start from the eye, left eye, the eyeballs, right eye, and color them. The nose. Lips. Just remember that this is abstract face and you can draw any shape you want. You want to change the shape of the lips, you want to change the shape of the nose, you are free to do so. The neck. Okay, so the drawing is completed and now we are going to divide our this whole abstract face into various parts. So suppose let's start dividing on the right side. So we'll just mark lines like this with pencil. Okay, don't divide your face with marker. Just divide it with pencil. You just make one line here. Okay. It's very abstract. Nothing real. Like this. So we divided the right side of the face in horizontal curves like this, and the left side we'll just make some vertical lines. Like this. And even the eye can be divided like this. See? Both the eyes. the nose to various parts. So now our everything is divided, even this neck also. You can add some patterns, some shapes, anything you can add. And now we are going to color the whole face with some bright colors, really bright colors like red, green, yellow, orange, purple, pink, or whatever you have. So what we start with, let's start with red. Let's take some red. So if you want to divide your abstract face, you can. If you don't want to divide, you can just divide it into half. Okay, like suppose let me just show you this nose part. So I'm just coloring this red, and the rest can be colored with some other color. Rest can be done with orange or with purple or with pink, any color like this. Or you want to do it part wise, you are free to do it part wise. I'll just show you how to color the whole abstract face. So the complete artwork will look something like this, and you can add your own patterns, your own designs to complete your artwork. You can add different colors, different patterns. Like I've done here triangles and V shapes. You can add some polka dots, spirals, whatever you learned till now. And you can even use, I've used here oil pastels and sketch pens. And for the outline, I've used bold markers. Or you can just use simple sketch pens and just double outline them like this. Just boldly double outline them like this, so that your artwork comes out really nice and the outline enhances your coloring portion. Okay, just share the images with me and just write down your name and class on the right side of the artwork. And thank you so much. Hope you've enjoyed this class. Have a good day.